Hello, grade ones. Welcome back. My name is Robin, and today in numeracy, we are going to be learning about odd and even numbers. So let's meet some new friends. Today, we are going to meet even Stephen and odd Todd. They are going to help us learn about odd and even numbers. So, what are odd and even numbers, grade ones? Well, an even number is a number that can be divided or put into two equal groups. An odd number is a number that cannot be divided or put into two equal groups. So remember, even Stephen and odd Todd are going to help us understand these numbers a bit better. So let's have a look at even numbers. Even Stephen says, when you're with Stephen, everyone has a partner. So this means that there are two of something. So if we have a look at the numbers over here, we can see that each number has a partner. So there are two of the numbers. Fours have a partner, six have a partner, eight have a partner, and 10 have a partner. And even Stephen wants us to remember that even numbers always end with a 0, a 2, a 4, or an 8 digit. So this means, for example, if we have the number 10 ends in the digit 0. So this tells us that it is an even number. Let's have a look at what else even Stephen has to say. Groups of even numbers. When we group a number into two groups and there is an equal amount, so this means there is the same amount of items in each group, then we say that the number is even. For example, over here we can see that even Stephen has six dots, and he has put them into groups of three. So the first group has three dots, and the second group also has three dots. We can see that there is an equal amount in each group. So this means that it is an even number. Groups of two. Even Stephen says that you need to remember when you're with Stephen, everyone has a partner. So Stephen likes to have a friend with him all the time, which is his partner. And remember, even numbers end with a 0, a 2, a 4, or an 8 digit. Another example would be number 18. We can see that this number ends with the digit 8. So we know that it is an even number because it ends in the digit 8. If we group a number into groups of two with no remainder, then we say that it is an even number. So this means, grade ones, that if we put the number into groups of two and there is nothing left over, we have nothing left, no remainders, then we know that it is an even number. So let's look at our example. Even Stephen has six dots over here, and he wants to put them into groups of two. So here is one group, there is his next group, and there is his third group. So can you see, grade ones, that each group has two dots? And can you see any dots left over? No, there are no dots left over, which means there are no remainders. And we know that this means it is now an even number because each group got the same amount. Now let's have a look at what odd Todd has to say. We know that Odd Todd is a bit strange, and sometimes Odd Todd does not like to have a partner with him. So when you're with Odd Todd, not everyone has a partner. So let's have a look at the numbers. We can see number one does not have a partner because there is only one dot. Here we only have three dots, and this number does not have a partner. Over here we have five dots, and we can see that the fifth dot does not have a partner. If we have a look at number seven, we can see that all the dots except the last one does not have a partner. Number nine, we can see that the first eight dots have a partner, and the last one does not have a partner. So this dot might be feeling a little bit sad. So remember, when we have Odd Todd, not everyone has a partner. When looking at odd numbers, grade ones, we need to remember that odd numbers can end in number one or digit one, digit three, digit five, digit seven, or digit nine. So if, for example, we have the number 11, is it going to be an odd or an even number, grade ones? Fantastic! It is going to be an odd number. And why is that? Because the number ends in the digit 1. So remember what Odd Todd said? That if an odd number ends in 1, 3, 5, 7, or 9, these digits tell us that it is an odd number. So let's look at groups of odd numbers. When we group a number into two groups with an equal amount of items in each group, but we have one remainder, we then say that the number is an odd number. So we can see that Odd Todd has seven dots, and he wants to put them into equal groups. So we can see that here is his first group, and there is his second group. But can you see, grade ones, that we have over here one remainder? So this means that it is an odd number because we cannot fit them into two equal groups. Groups of two. So the important thing that Odd Todd says is that not everyone has a partner. So if we group a number into groups of two, we have a remainder, then we say that it is an odd number. So again, we can see that Odd Todd has seven dots, and he has put the dots into groups of two. So here is his first group, there is his second group, and here is his third group. And now we can see, grade ones, that there is one dot remaining or left over. So this means that it is an odd number because there is an odd dot out. So we can see that this dot does not have a partner, which means that it is an odd number. Again, remember, grade ones, that odd numbers end in the digits 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. For example, if we have the number 15, is it going to be an odd or an even number? Very well done, grade ones. It is going to be an odd number because the number ends in the digit 5. Fantastic. Let's have a look at our next slide. We are now going to practice our odd and even numbers. So we are first going to fill in the missing numbers, and then we are going to decide are the missing numbers odd or even? So we are going to write our answer in the spaces provided. And let's have a look at the first example. We can see in the number line over here that the missing numbers were 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20. And what can you see about these missing numbers, grade ones? Yes, these numbers end in 2, 4, 6, 8, and 0. So this means that they are even numbers. Good work. So we can see over here that we need to write the even numbers are missing. So let's do another one together. Let's have a look at our number line. So our first number is missing, and then our second number in the number line is 46. Then the next number is missing, and our next number is 48. So if we go to the start of our number line, grade ones, what number comes before 46? Very good. It is going to be number 45. Then we have 46. And which number comes after 46? We have 47. Then we have 48. The number after 48 is going to be 49. Then we have 50. Our next number is going to be 51. Then we have 52. The next missing number is going to be 53. Good work. The next number is going to be 54. And the last missing number on our number line is going to be 55. And then we have 56. Now that we have completed our number line, let's have a look at the numbers that we have filled in. We can see that the missing numbers we have filled in end in 5, 7, 9, 1, 3, and 5. And we remember that Odd Todd told us that odd numbers end in digits of 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. So looking at this number line, grade ones, can you tell me what numbers are missing? Yes, very good. It is the odd numbers that are missing. So let's write in the missing word. It is going to be odd. Now let's have a look at our next one. We are going to first fill in the missing numbers on our number line. So we have 33, 32, 31. And then which number comes after 31 if we are counting backwards? It is going to be number 30. Then we have 29. If we go counting backwards, it is going to be 28, 27, 26, 25, 24, 23, and 22. So if we look at this number line, grade ones, can you see what numbers each number ends in? We can see that they end in the digits of 2, 4, 6, and 8. And what did even Stephen tell us about those digits? They tell us that they are even numbers. So we can see that the missing numbers on this number line are even numbers. Well done, grade ones. You should be proud of the work that you have done today. That is all we have time for odd and even numbers. Remember to keep practicing at home, and thank you very much for joining me today. Until next time, goodbye.